So what's going on, guys? It's JM, it's Speedboxing. Make sure you subscribe to my channel before you click onto any of my videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of my videos. Really helps me out if you guys could drop me a sub or two on my channel, it is appreciated. So last night we saw Anthony Joshua v Vladimir Klitschko in front of 90,000 people at Wembley Stadium. Anthony Joshua stopped Vladimir Klitschko in the 11th round to become the new unified heavyweight champion of the world. And I did a little review after the fight, but it was straight after the fight and I had to nip out, so the video is only about 2.5 minutes long, so I'm going to break the fight down more here and talk about what's next for both fighters. And in my opinion, the fight last night was probably one of the best fights in the heavyweight division I've seen in the past 15 years. Both guys showed a lot of heart and determination. Both guys showed a real will to win in the fight. And the fight started off a bit cautious, both guys trying to establish something in the fight, both trying to land shots, and it was a bit of a slow first couple of rounds. And then in the third round, you could tell that Vladimir Klitschko was the technically better fighter in there, and you could tell that straight away. But it's not really surprising, because Anthony Joshua was only in his 19th fight tonight against Vladimir Klitschko, and he only had about 40 fights as an amateur, and Vladimir Klitschko has been boxing for about 27 years. That's a long time. That's as long as Anthony Joshua has been alive. So you could tell straight away that Vladimir Klitschko had so much more experience. And in the fourth round, Vladimir Klitschko hit Joshua with a shot that seemed to just sap the whole life away from Anthony Joshua. It was a big shot that rocked him. And after that shot, Anthony Joshua seemed to tire a little bit. Like, it just took all the energy away from him, that big shot in the fourth round that just snapped his head back from Vladimir Klitschko, that big hook. But then we came out for the fifth round and Anthony Joshua managed to land a left hook, a big left hook that dropped Vladimir Klitschko to his knees, and Vladimir Klitschko beat the count. And everyone thought, oh, it's going to end quickly now, because Anthony Joshua is an excellent finisher. We've seen that in all of his fights. Obviously, he's got 100% KO ratio. And Vladimir Klitschko managed to survive, because there was still about 2 minutes left in the round, and Vladimir Klitschko managed to survive it. And Klitschko came out in the sixth round and landed a massive right hand that dropped Anthony Joshua. Like, Anthony Joshua was hurt. He was dropped. He got back up. He was wobbling all over the place. And that was the thing tonight that was really bothering Anthony Joshua, the right hand from Vladimir Klitschko. And that long right hand was really bothering Anthony Joshua. And that's got me thinking, if you fight somebody like Deontay Wilder, whose main weapon is his big, long right hand, how's Anthony Joshua going to cope against it? Because Deontay Wilder hits a lot harder than Vladimir Klitschko, in my opinion, and his right hand is more of a weapon. So yeah, if that fight's made, that'd be something Joshua would need to work on, trying to get away from the right hand. And it seemed to be really bothering him in the fight. But then, after the knockdown of Joshua, Joshua seemed to be hurt for the next couple of rounds. He didn't really get his bearings back until a few rounds later, and that's when Vladimir Klitschko started to really get into the fight, establishing the jab. And I think Vladimir Klitschko was actually up on the scorecards at the time of the stoppage. But by the 10th round, Anthony Joshua kind of got his bearings back and started throwing heavy shots at Vladimir Klitschko. And then he came out in the 11th round and landed a huge uppercut on Vladimir Klitschko, a huge uppercut on Vladimir Klitschko, who was rocked to his boots. Anthony Joshua jumped on him with a barrage of shots, and Klitschko fell down, and the referee started to count. Klitschko got back up, and then Anthony Joshua again hit him with a solid shot to the side of the head, and Klitschko went down like a falling tree. And I've got to give Klitschko credit. He could have just stayed down on that shot, and nobody would have really blamed him. Because he's 41 years of age, he just took a massive shot. No one was expecting him to really get up, because come on now, he's 41 years of age, he's a future Hall of Famer, he cemented his legacy. He didn't have to get up, but he got up, and it showed the competitor in Vladimir Klitschko, and I really give him credit for doing that. But then just moments later, Anthony Joshua jumped on him, landed another barrage of shots, and the referee had seen enough and stopped the fight. And Anthony Joshua becomes the unified heavyweight champion of the world and put on a fantastic performance to come back, because he was hurt. He was being outboxed, Anthony Joshua. But his power tonight showed that it was real, and it was really his equaliser in the fight that got him the victory. So I take my hats off to Anthony Joshua. And a lot of people were saying Anthony Joshua was going to gas late on, and that's when Vladimir Klitschko was going to get him. And Anthony Joshua was tired, especially when he got hurt, but I don't know, he managed to find something in them later rounds, and nobody expected that from Anthony Joshua, and he deserves the credit for that, and I hope people give it him. And what's next for Anthony Joshua? Well, he's got a mandatory for the WBA title. Lewis King Kong Ortiz, that's a very dangerous fight for Anthony Joshua. Lewis King Kong Ortiz is very powerful. I think that would be a big fight for Anthony Joshua. I think he should take it. He's saying that he wants to fight all comers in the heavyweight division. He called out Tyson Fury, but even though Tyson Fury has started training again, I still see him having a long way to go before he comes back and is able to fight at a high level, because he's still got a lot of weight to shed. He put on a lot of weight, and we don't know what's going on inside of his head. He's been having a lot of issues with his mental health and stuff like that. And also, Anthony Joshua could fight Deontay Wilder in a huge unification. Like I just said, if Anthony Joshua takes the fight against Deontay Wilder, he's going to need to learn to get away from a right hand, because that right hand of Deontay Wilder is no joke. And I'm telling you, if he hits Joshua clean, well, as clean as Klitschko did when he knocked him down, then I don't think Anthony Joshua is getting up. And as for Vladimir Klitschko, he's trying to say it's not going to be the end for him. He wants to rematch against Anthony Joshua. And I admire him for saying that, because in my opinion, he was winning the fight. It was close, but he was winning it. And he showed a lot of heart, and he looked so motivated tonight, and he did look the better fighter in there when it came to technical ability. So I understand him wanting the rematch, but if I was Vladimir Klitschko, I'd just retire. I think I'd just ride off into the sunset. He's earned a lot of money. He's going to go down as a legend of the sport. He's done a lot of great things for boxing. He's got a lot of charity work out there, and he really is a legend of the sport. Love him or hate him, if you don't like his style and stuff like that, if you thought he was boring, but the guy got it done for 11 years and people should respect him for that. But he's a competitor and he says he wants the rematch, so we don't know what's going to happen. But I don't see Anthony Joshua getting back in the ring with Vladimir Klitschko, because he was close to losing tonight. I see Anthony Joshua having another big fight, possibly against one of the other champions, or maybe his mandatory Lewis Ortiz, or another heavyweight contender like Kubrat Pulev, who's number one with the IBF. I think Anthony Joshua has to vacate one of his titles, I heard. If I was him, I'd vacate the IBF, because I don't know, I think I'd rather fight Lewis Ortiz, even if it's a dangerous fight. I think that's the fight that's going to get the public interest. And Kubrat Pulev, it's not the kind of fight that the fans are going to get excited for. I think Kubrat Pulev has the same personality as a fork, so I expect Lewis Ortiz to be more of a character. Even though he don't really speak English, when he gets translated to English, he seems like a real character, and he does say some very outspoken things. So yeah, this is just my review on this fight. I went into more depth. Comment below your opinion on the fight. It's JM.